Hello dear students, welcome to lecture 5 on the chapter Ray Optics and Optical Instruments. Students, in lecture 4 we discussed about refraction, Snell's law and lateral shift, and finally we discussed about normal shift. In this lecture we are going to discuss on total internal reflection and illustrations for total internal reflection. Okay, now let us discuss these two topics one by one. Total internal reflection. Okay, we know what is reflection, right? Okay, if a ray of light has to undergo total internal reflection, then the ray must travel from denser medium to rarer medium. If the ray travels from rarer medium to denser medium, then there is no total internal reflection. Okay, now let us see the definition of total internal reflection. Okay, in short it is called as TIR. When a ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, it is incident on the interface of the two media at an angle greater than the critical angle, the ray is totally reflected back into the denser medium, and this phenomena is called total internal reflection. Okay, now let us understand this total internal reflection by a small demonstration. Consider two media. Okay, one medium is rarer medium and other medium is denser medium, and these two are separated by the interface, and that interface is shown by a line. Consider an illuminated object O placed in denser medium. A ray of light OA falls normally at the interface of two media and travels undeviated. Okay, here a ray OA falls normally at the interface and it travels undeviated. It does not change its direction. Consider another ray OP falls on the interface at an angle I and gets refracted at an angle R. See, we are considering another ray and it is obliquely incident at the interface, and the refracted ray gets away from the, or bends away from the normal. It travels along this direction, making an angle of refraction R. As the angle of incidence increases, the refracted ray bends away from the normal. See, by these two rays, initially there is no change in the direction of incident ray when it travels from denser medium to rarer medium, and in second case when a ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, it bends away from the normal. It is changing its direction. Further, consider another ray at a particular angle of incidence. The refracted ray travels along the interface and the angle of refraction is 90 degree. Okay, we have another ray OQ at a particular angle of incidence. The refracted ray travels along the interface. Okay, well, it travels along the interface and the angle of refraction is 90 degree. The angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction is 90 degree is called critical angle. Okay, the angle of incidence for which angle of refraction is 90 degree is called critical angle. Further, when the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, there is no refraction and all the incident light is reflected in the denser medium, and this phenomena is known as total internal reflection. See, here we are considering another ray and that is incident at the interface with an angle greater than critical angle. Then there is no refraction, all the incident light is reflected back in the same medium, in the denser medium, and this phenomena is called total internal reflection. I hope you understood what is total internal reflection. Okay, now let us define critical angle. When a ray of light travels from denser medium to rarer medium, the angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction is 90 degree is called critical angle. Okay, it is shown in this diagram. When a ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium, the angle of incidence for which angle of refraction is 90 degree is called critical angle. Okay, now let us give the relation between refractive index of the denser medium and critical angle. Okay, with the help of this ray diagram, we are going to give the relation between refractive index and critical angle. Already we know what is refractive index and what is critical angle. A ray of light is incident at a critical angle on the interface of two medium from denser medium. See, a ray of light is incident at interface of two medium from denser medium, and let L1 be the refractive index of denser medium and N2 is the refractive index of rarer medium. Then by Snell's law, N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. Okay, this is expression given by Snell's law, that is N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. Then that is equal to N1 sin C is equal to N2 sin 90. Okay, here angle of incidence is equal to critical angle and it is represented by C, and angle of refraction is equal to 90 degree. Hence we are substituting these values in this equation. Okay, then N1 sin C is equal to N2. Sin 90 degree is equal to 1. Therefore, that is equal to N2. Hence, sin C is equal to N2 divided by N1. Okay, this is the relation between refractive index of first medium with respect to second medium. If the rarer medium is air medium, then the refractive index N2 is equal to 1 and refractive index N1 is equal to N. Now substituting these values in the above equation, we get N is equal to 1 divided by C. Okay, this is the relation between refractive index and critical angle when the rarer medium is air medium. Now let us see the conditions for total internal reflections. What are the conditions? First condition is the ray of light should travel from denser medium to rarer medium. Okay, this is first condition. The ray must travel from denser medium to rarer medium. Second condition, the angle of incidence in the denser medium should be greater than the critical angle. Okay, if the ray has to undergo total internal reflection, then the angle of incidence in the denser medium should be greater than the critical angle. Okay, these two are the two conditions for total internal reflection. Okay, these two conditions are important one. Usually they will be asking question on these two conditions. Illustrations for total internal reflection. Okay, here in this topic, we are going to discuss few illustrations for total internal reflection. First one, sparkling of diamond or brilliance in diamond. Okay, we have seen the diamond, right? Okay, due to a proper shape of diamond, when a light enters the diamond, that light undergoes multiple total internal reflection, and due to this, the diamond shines brilliantly. Diamond has a refractive index of 2.4 and critical angle is very small, which is equal to 24.41 degree. Okay, now let us see how the diamond shines. Okay, this is the picture of diamond. A white light is incident at one of the phase and that light gets refracted, and this refracted light undergoes multiple total internal reflection and then emerges through one of its phase. Okay, here the light is white light, that means it is moving normally, and here the light gets refracted and it undergoes dispersion, and these two rays are emerging out with an angle lesser than the critical angle. Hence this causes sparkling of diamond or brilliance in diamond. Second one, mirages. It is the optical illusion seen during hot summer days due to total internal reflection. Okay, let me give one example. During hot summer, if you were traveling in the bus, you might have seen the patches of water on the road at a certain distance. When you reach that place, the patches of water disappears. Okay, that is due to total internal reflection. Okay, let us understand this by taking one more example. Okay, during hot summer days, the air near the surface of the earth is hotter and the upper layers are cooler. Hence, the air which is hotter has low refractive index and the upper layers are cooler, hence they have high refractive, or the refractive index is more. Okay, if you assume that if a light is coming from a tall object like tree, then as that light moves, the refracted ray at every layer of the air will move away or will bend away from the normal, and at a lower layer the ray is incident with an angle greater than critical angle, hence it gets totally internally reflected back, and the distance observer feels that the image is formed somewhere in the ground, feeling that the image is formed on the pool of the water. Okay, this illusion is called mirage. Third one, prism designed to bend the light by 90 degree or 180 degree by making use of total internal reflection. Okay, here we have a prism, isosceles triangle prism, and a beam of light is incident on this prism with an angle greater than critical angle, and that critical angle is equal to 45 degree, and these rays are bent by 90 degree as shown in the figure. Okay, we have one more prism here. A beam of light from object AB travels along the straight line and are incident at one phase, and the ray gets reflected and it is incident on another phase, and again that ray gets reflected and it emerges out of prism and forms an image. Here the beam of light is reflected or bent by 180 degree. Okay, this is due to total internal reflection. Okay, it is another illusion for total internal reflection. Next one, optical fibers. Optical fibers are the thin transparent fibers of glass or plastic which can transmit light through any curved path. It works on the principle of total internal reflection. Okay, they are fibers, you can bend that and the light can be sent or transmitted through any curved path. If you bend, the light will travel along the curved path of the optical fiber. Okay, it is used for communication and other purposes. Okay, this is the diagram of optical fibers. Okay, it is made up of two layers. The inner layer is called as core, having high refractive index, and another layer is called cladding, having low refractive index. When an ray of light enters the fiber with an angle of incidence greater than the critical angle, it undergoes total internal reflection between the interface of core and cladding. See, it is shown here. The ray is entering with an angle greater than critical angle, then it undergoes total internal reflection and it emerges out at the other end. KT is another illusion for total internal reflection. Now let us see the uses of optical fibers. First use, they are used in long distance communication to transmit optical signals. Second one, they are used as endoscopes to examine the organs of human body. Okay, they are used in hospital to examine the organs of human body. Third one, they are used to measure refractive index of liquids. Fourth one, they are used to measure temperature, pressure and flow of liquid. Fifth one, they are used for decorative purpose. Okay, you might have seen the decoration, right? Okay, even the optical fibers are used for decorative purposes. Okay, these are the few uses of optical fibers. Last topic, uses or applications of total internal reflection. First one, it is used in sparkling of diamond or brilliance of diamond. Second, total internal reflections are used in optical fibers. Third one, they are used in total reflecting prisms. Okay, these are the few uses of total internal reflection. Thank you, students, and we'll be learning some more topics on this chapter in the next lecture.